I spend about 30 hours a week staring at my phone. So how about we reclaim our time and sanity in 2025? And these tech resolutions for the new year will help us do just that. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodian. Welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews. And it's time we ditch the digital clutter and learn how to clear our clutter and organize our digital lives. Ah, doesn't that sound zen? Let's go. The first tech resolution I recommend for the new year is to back up your data, like all of your data. So you need to be thinking about your computer, your phone, all of your photos, heck, even your emails. So I usually start with an external hard drive and I run Time Machine on my MacBook Pro to ensure I've got an up-to-date backup of my computer. Now, when it comes to photos, all of my photos auto backup with Google Photos. And I'll touch on clearing the digital clutter in a little bit, but when it comes to backing up my iPhone, couple of things. I regularly back up and sync my device using my MacBook Pro, but I also use iExplorer to back up data from my phone. So think things like photos, music, and even messages. Yes, I keep a backup of all my messages. Is that weird? I typically do this once a year, and iExplorer works for iPhone and iPad, and it's just an extra backup layer for me. And when it comes to emails, did you know you could back those up too? So here's how to do that in Gmail. You're gonna head to myaccount.google.com and navigate to Manage Your Data and Privacy. Then you're gonna scroll down to the Download or Delete Data section and click on Download Your Data. This brings up Google Takeout, where you can export a copy of all of your content in your Google account. So this includes things like contacts and calendar and Drive and photos and yes, even Gmail. Seriously, you can back up like all of your Google account data. It's awesome. Now the next tech resolution I'm setting is to organize my life digitally. So here are some tips on how to organize your digital life. First, when you have created your backups, make sure everything is properly stored and properly named in a way that makes sense for you. So when I back up my work drives, for example, everything is organized per year, or sometimes I have it per client. You could organize it per project, whatever makes sense for you. Now, when it comes to browser tabs, I keep only open the ones that I am currently using. And I've pinned my most used YouTube tab, so it's always available to me, but not taking up a ton of room. To pin a tab in Chrome, you're just gonna right click on it and select pin. Now, when it comes to my desktop itself, somehow no matter how many times I clean it up by the end of the year, it's anxiety inducing. So take some time to organize your desktop files and frankly, while you're at it, organize your downloads and files that might be stored maybe in a different place. But let's not just focus on organizing our computers and our web browsers, because there's a lot of organization that can happen on our phones as well. Now is the time to go through your phone and rearrange any apps that maybe aren't in the right folders. And obviously make sure your most used apps are up front, because sometimes our preferences change. But we can't talk digital organization without talking about clearing the digital clutter. Oh Lord, we could talk about this all day. Don't worry, we won't. So we just organized our apps, but while we're making our tech resolutions, why not delete all of your unused apps? Clear that clutter. I promise you, it feels so good. Like, do we really need all these apps? It's overwhelming. I say no thank you. And remember how I said I use iExplorer to back up all the data, including messages from my iPhone? Well, I do that right before I clean house on my iPhone. That's right, I typically once a year, after I back everything up, delete all my messages from my device. The same goes for my photos. I completely clear house. Now remember, all my photos automatically get backed up to Google Photos, so I have a copy of them in the cloud. Plus, I'm backing up via iExplorer, where I save those on a physical hard drive. Then, and only then, I clear house. Now, speaking of Google Photos, I actually go in there and I clean house too. So things like old screen recordings for these videos that I don't need taking up space here because I have them stored on external hard drives with all of my YouTube files. Those get deleted. Old screenshots I don't need. Those go bye-bye too. We also organized all our computer files, but while we're at it, why not delete any unnecessary files and free up space? I somehow found myself with a lot of digital clutter on my MacBook Pro, so this is so needed. Same goes for apps here too. Are there any Mac apps or Windows apps that you have that you never use? Get rid of them. And something often overlooked are bookmarks. Yeah, bet you haven't thought about those in a while. I know I haven't. I use Chrome, so I'm gonna head to my three-dot menu icon in the top right and head to my bookmarks and lists, and then I'm gonna click on my bookmark manager. And what is even happening here? Look at all of these. And some of these, most of these, are more than 10 years old. OMG. So let's clear that clutter. You could do it one at a time, or you could select a bookmark, hit your shift key to select multiple, to delete a bunch at once. Woo! And by the way, we talked backing up your email, but you should clear the clutter there too. So if you want videos all on how to free up Gmail space and how to create labels, I've got those linked for you in the description below. But also actively make sure you're unsubscribing to emails that no longer serve you. I swear to you, most of the emails I wake up to every single morning are spam or from lists that I really don't care about. Let's change this for 2025. And luckily, Gmail makes it super easy to unsubscribe from messages that you're no longer interested in. Godspeed. And by the way, if you're finding this video valuable so far, remember to give it a like and subscribe to my channel for more content just like this. All right, we can't talk about tech resolutions for the new year without talking about mindful tech use, says the girl with nearly 30 hours of screen time every week. First, I'm going to try something I'm calling the intentional hour. I'm going to attempt to pick 1 hour a day where I use technology with a specific purpose in mind, like maybe I'm learning or creating or connecting with loved ones, and try to avoid mindless scrolling. This will be difficult because I'm nothing if not a mindless scroller. Will you attempt an intentional hour with me? Comment below so we can get through this together. Next, I'm gonna set up app time limits. We're gonna see how long I stick to that, but I'm on Instagram way too much for anything good to happen. It has to end. I'm so sorry, Instagram. I'm doing this because I love you too much. And something else I've implemented that I'm going to continue doing into 2025 are no phone zones. For example, when we're eating a meal together, it's a no phone zone. If I'm with family and friends that I don't see a lot of time and I want to actually connect, it's a no phone zone. And I also think it's important to work on reclaiming focus in 2025. I've been using focus mode a lot lately when I'm working and I can't have the distractions. I get a lot more done when notifications aren't going off every other second. So I'm curious to know how you're being mindful with tech. Is it app time limits? Is it do not disturb? Is it something I've never heard of before? What are your tech resolutions? Let me know in the comments below, but without spending too much time online, of course. Just leave a nice comment and then offline you go. No, seriously, go. Oh, you're still here? Cool, thanks. As always, thank you so much for watching. And if you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or you can leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for more content just like this. Thanks for watching. See you next time.